Welcome to the Fit Small Business QuickBooks Online Training Course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to run a statement of cash flows in QuickBooks Online. To follow along with me, log into your QuickBooks Online account now or click the link below for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. You can also click this link to access our full QuickBooks Online course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. The statement of cash flows shows the flow of cash within the business, including where it came from and how it was spent during a specific time period. Depending on the type of transaction, cash flow is categorized into three types of activities: operating activities, investing activities, and financing activities. Operating activities shows how much cash was generated from operations, which make up the day-to-day running of the business. Investing activities shows how much cash was generated from assets purchased for the business, such as equipment. Regardless of whether the transaction was paid in cash or financed, it would appear under investing activities. In addition, any portion that was financed will also appear under financing activities. Financing activities shows the cash that has come in or gone out of the company for the purpose of financing all of the other business activities. For example, any funds invested in the business by the owner and any loans would show up in this section. Cash flow is essential to stay in business. If you don't have enough cash to meet your obligations and to reinvest, then you won't be in business very long. In the How to Run a Profit and Loss Statement lesson, we discuss the importance of reviewing your income and expenses and looking for trends that can give you insight into the contributing factors to your bottom line. In the How to Run a Balance Sheet lesson, we discussed how that report will provide you with the net worth of your business as of a point in time. However, these two reports alone cannot tell you everything that you need to know to make good business decisions. You need all three reports, the profit and loss statement, the balance sheet, and the statement of cash flows to give you a complete picture of the health of your business. To demonstrate the components of the cash flow statement, we will take a look at the cash flow statement for a fictitious company, Paul's Plumbing. As we discussed previously, there are three sections of the cash flow statement, as shown here by the three red boxes. There are also several different terms you need to understand. Net income. This figure will directly come from the bottom line of your profit and loss statement. The net income here is $2,091.53. Net cash provided by operating activities. This section is comprised of the net cash inflow and outflow of the day-to-day business operations. For Paul's Plumbing, this includes any cash generated from the sale of plumbing products and services. Net cash provided by operating activities is $7,611.73, as indicated here in item 2. Net cash provided by investing activities. This section is comprised of the net cash inflow and outflow of any investments made in the business. Paul purchased a truck to use in his business, so that purchase is listed here as a cash outflow item of $10,000. Net cash provided by financing activities. This section is comprised of the net cash inflow and outflow of any type of financing that supports the business operations. In this example, Paul financed a truck, so the amount of the loan that he took to purchase the truck is listed in this section as a cash inflow item. Net cash provided by financing activities is $12,255.99 here in item number 4. Net cash increase for the period is $9,867.72 as indicated in item number 5. It is the total of all three activities: operating activities, investing activities, and the financing activities. Cash at the end of the period. This is going to be the total of cash at the beginning of the period. In this example, that was $5,500 plus the net cash increase that we just discussed of $9,867.72. That gives us a total of cash at the end of the period of $15,367.72. Let's go ahead and go into QuickBooks and run a statement of cash flows. From the home screen, you want to go ahead and click on the reports menu on the left-hand side. From this screen, you want to make sure that you are on the All Reports tab, and then you want to scroll down and locate the link that says Statement of Cash Flows. From this screen, we've got several options similar to what we saw with our balance sheet report and our profit and loss statement. So first button is the print button, which allows you to print a hard copy of the report. The email option allows you to email this report to anyone that you would like to review it, for example, your CPA or tax professional. The export button, if you click the arrow to the right, you have the option to export this report to Excel. The customize button, this feature allows you to customize a number of areas of the report. This includes general areas of the report, as you can see here. You can customize the rows and columns, lists, the numbers and how they're formatted, and the header and footer information here. The next thing you'd want to do is determine the time period that you'd like to run the statement of cash flows for. So you can select from the drop-down the preset transaction dates that QuickBooks has, or you can actually enter a specific time frame here in this particular box. Once you make your selections, be sure to click the Run Report button, and you've got your statement of cash flows. Now that you have a better understanding of what the statement of cash flows will tell you about your business and how to create one in QuickBooks Online, there are a few things you should implement as soon as possible. As you now know, the statement of cash flows pulls several key numbers from both the profit and loss statement and the balance sheet. Therefore, it is very important that the following have taken place before you run a statement of cash flows. First, be sure QuickBooks is up to date with all income and expenses. Second, reconcile all bank and credit card accounts. Third, be sure to resolve any discrepancies found in your review of the profit and loss statement and the balance sheet report. For more information on the profit and loss statement and balance sheet, view our other lessons by clicking this link here. Make sure all assets and liabilities have been recorded in QuickBooks. And finally, review your statement of cash flows on a monthly basis. That wraps up the lesson on how to run a statement of cash flows in QuickBooks Online. To access our full QuickBooks Online course or any of the other lessons in this series, click this link. You can also find a link below this video for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. If you have feedback about this course or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.